SBS television.
Hi.
Just looking around people like you and asking them, what is that thing?
This one here.
Yes, that one there. Can we have a look?
Yes, you can have a look. That's a pendant.
I don't...
Wow. Well, besides I do this, I do astrology. I'm probably the world's astrological genius, you may say. That's not true.
And the world's best delicatessen owner.
Yeah, I do all these most of the time.
How do you split up your two vocations?
Yeah, food and philosophy, right?
Yeah.
Okay, they're both nurturing to the public. That's what you got to do.
Right. But what about your own work? I mean, you work here during the day and then you do astrology at night?
No, this is only 4 days. We do 4 days of this, you know, because we have to prepare the markets and, you know,
right,
get ready for the public. And the rest of the time, you got to have, everybody has a hobby.
Right.
Some people like tennis.
Yes.
So I sit there and I sell software, actually.
You sell software?
Yep.
Astrological
software.
Right.
That's what I do. And I'm basically involved in that.
How did you get interested in astrology?
Well, curiosity, I suppose, like everything else, you know, you have to have an interest.
Was this a long time ago?
Oh, about 3 years ago.
Only 3 years?
Yeah.
And you're the world's greatest already.
Nah, I wish I was. I'm an observer of human quality, I suppose, you know. I want to know what makes people tick. Countries.
Yeah.
For instance, I sell programs like stock market programs. I represent number one and number two companies in the world, Air Software and Cosmic Patterns. So today, more and more, as we're getting into computers and we're getting into the high-tech era, people with computers on their homes use astrology to find out their events in front of their lives. For instance, today I've got a guy I'm selling the stock market program. Hey, he works for the stock markets. I don't like to do readings.
No.
It takes 20 years and it's Eastern and Western astrology. And to become an astrologer, I'm still studying at the moment.
Oh, I see. So you're studying.
I respect the signs.
Yes.
To become an astrologer and call yourself an astrologer, it takes 20 years.
What is your star sign?
I'm a Taurus star sign.
Tell us about Taurus.
Well, Taurus likes food, as you can see, that's why we're
going to
dab.
Typical
terrain you'll find them behind the banks, as an accountant, as a banker, probably running stock markets. Financial aspects.
But why is that? What is the characteristic?
Farming.
Makes them
they're earthbound, they're
bull.
Solid, you know,
Taurus,
they have
the bull, yeah.
They have to be grounded, you know.
Yes.
If it doesn't work, for instance, for me, one of my greatest beliefs, why I use astrology, so clairvoyance or anything like that, if you can't actually prove it, then walk away, you know.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you have to have the facts there.
Right.
Practical, they have to be practical, they're practical people, you know.
Yes.
What I mean?
Yes, I see.
You know, it's like...
Are you married? I thought that was an easy question.
Getting close to it.
Okay, what is your philosophy about relationships? What is it that you're hoping to...
Relationships. I think it's the greatest thing that we have in our favor in relationships, that we never can get dull in relationships. Never.
Mm.
I think if you look at it optimistically, the fact that we're all so unique. And in astrology we say it takes 29,500 years to have the identical blueprint. That means as you are, someone else will come. So it's just exciting, you know, and the fact that we can all be so different.
What is your ethnic background?
This is it. The country of philosophy and all that stuff. Greece.
And were you born there?
Yes, I was.
Yeah. And how old were you when you came to Australia?
14. Probably the best years of my life, because anybody's childhood, you know.
Yeah, you had a great childhood.
Yeah, you know, like, you know, you remember your school days, you remember your upbringing, you remember your mates there, your playground, you know, all that stuff. The excursions we had in all the temples in Parthenon and Delphi and all those things. I remember, like, yesterday, those things. You can never forget those.
Yeah.
I've been a mechanic, a Jaguar Mercedes specialist for about 20 years.
That's a long time.
Yes, that was the main motive, you know.
Why did you leave that after 20 years?
I think every mechanic will leave after 20 years, you know, like nuts and bolts every day, you know.
And you knew probably all there was to know about the subject.
Yeah, that was it, you know. It's, you know, like that change is the most wonderful thing we can have in our lives. It doesn't matter whether it's careers, it doesn't matter where it is, you know, it's beautiful, you know?
Change.
Yeah. Because we have different approaches of looking at things. We don't stagnate to the same mode. Mm-hmm. And I think that's one thing Australia has in favour. Mm-hmm. It's constantly changing. Mm-hmm. After 97, astrologically, right?
Yeah.
14th of February, 97, right? 96. Watch Australia. It will be recognised as a force to be reckoned with.
But you're here. Are you having...
5 years ago, that was.
5 years ago, you had some hair. Is it transplanting?
Yes, it calls forward thinking, you know.
what's the system? What does it do? Does it grow? Is it sort of...
Something? Yes, it's natural. It's called scalp reduction.
Yeah.
I've seen too many Indians do it in the movies, so I thought I'll try it.
And it's more on this, on your right-hand side, isn't it?
Yeah, I don't know why, but anyway. I wasn't looking at the mirror then.
From SBS doing a series of documentaries about people, and we just wondered if you were locals or...
Yeah, local, mate.
Are you?
Yeah.
Have you been here all your life?
No, I've been here about 4 years.
What brought you up here?
My parents, mate. They moved up here and I was living with them.
All right. Are you still living with them?
No. No.
Moved out and...
Thank Christ.
How did you two meet?
We were having lunch.
Yeah. She was having lunch and I just turned up and went from there. I put on the moves, you know?
Do you remember what the first thing you said to her was?
I remember.
Do you remember?
Yeah, I was selling t-shirts, sales rep for a surf company. He walks up, he says, "Are you selling those?" I said, "Yeah, you're interested?" And he goes, "Oh, only because you're selling them." And then that was it.
And what did you think? You think that was it?
I thought I can handle him.
I gather, I mean, I'm just assuming here that these two tattoos were done at the same time?
No, they weren't actually. I've had mine for quite some time.
Uh-huh. And then you decided
to have meaning. Right?
Yeah, we met and the meaning's there. So.
The meaning?
Yeah, it's an American Indian tattoo. It means free spirit. Unlimited happiness.
Yeah. And that's a wish.
It means a lot to me.
Yeah. Mm. Why? Why does it...
Because I'm a free spirit, mate.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Okay. But the fact that it's American doesn't...
It's American Indian.
That's not the point, the fact that
no, well,
what
I've got
it
a,
means.
Yeah, it's what it means, but I've got a great... I've got a very big interest in the American Indians.
So, yeah.
You know, I like their way of life.
Mm-hmm.
And they're just so truthful, you know.
Where did this interest start? Do you remember?
Yeah, my father, actually.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, he's been over to the reservations and everything like that.
Mm-hmm.
Lives in the 60s.
Yeah.
He's awesome.
Yeah, he just lives in a shack, you know, in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah.
It's just a...
He's a free spirit too.
Yeah, he's just an old pot-smoking hippie, mate.
Yeah. Tell us what you like about this bloke here.
he's honesty.
He's honest.
Yeah.
What's that tattoo on the other side? There?
That's Celtic.
Uh-huh. Where were you heading now? Were you on the way to do some shopping?
Oh, no, not really. Just
cruising around.
Yeah.
Is any of these your cars?
No, I smashed mine.
Did you? What with?
A brick wall. A brick wall, mate. Fairly heavily intoxicated at the time.
You didn't get hurt?
No one was hurt, but just dented my pride a little more than anything.
Yeah.
Lost my license for 12 months.
Did you?
Shit happens, though.
Can we see your eyes?
Do you have to?
Just see what colour they are this morning.
Yeah. No, they're a little bit seedy this morning.
Why? Was it something late night?
Yeah, well, I was on the piss last night.
On a free spirit.
Yeah.
So it probably wasn't free.
So I took a sickie off work. Jeez, I hope the boss don't see this.
No, it'll be too late by then.
Well, he watches SBS.
My name's Dave. I like surfing around the coast here. I like blondes.
Hi, I'm Christian. I come from Italy and I like Australian women.
I like friendly women.
Okay, I'm Francesco and also that goes off for surfing. It's okay.
I like my mates, I like my friends, I like hanging around.
My My name's Jenny Mooney and I do ballroom dancing, and I'm in year 9 next year at school, but I need a partner for ballroom dancing. So if anyone wants to join ballroom dancing, go to Davidson Dance Centre at Cronulla. Stop. Stop.
You got a second for us? We're just from SBS Television.
Oh, are you? Okay, that's all right then.
That's all right then. Can we see behind the glasses? The person beneath? Do you work around here?
Yeah, I just work up the road.
What do you do?
I work as a barmaid.
What's the secret of getting tips?
You just give good service. You know, you get, you treat people the way you want to be treated yourself. If you do that, I don't think you can go wrong. Some people appreciate it, while others don't.
Yeah.
But you can only try your best, and if you do your best, you usually do pretty well.
What sort of family do you have? You know, in other words, are they normal people? Or
they're normal people, weirdos? Very normal people. Oh, no, sometimes they're weird. But I think they come down to it, they're very average sort of, you know, they're a good family.
You
no
like
complaint.
Them.
Like them a lot.
Yeah.
Like
do them you a still lot. Live with them?
No. That's why I can say I like them. My grandparents worked in a bottle shop. They ran a bottle shop for many years, and we used to serve there, and it feels like just an extension of that. But, you know, I've had several jobs, but when I was young, I used to think I was going to be a vet or a nurse, or midwife was a big one for a while. Yeah, but, you know.
Did you try any of those?
No.
Wait, how do you live? Are you living in a flat? Do you live alone?
I live in a house with three others.
Uh-huh.
Just down here in North Sydney.
Are they all in the hospitality industry?
No, none of them are.
What do they
do? They're all like overachievers. They're all at uni doing 2 degrees and working. So, so yeah.
Do they envy you, or do you envy them?
No, not at all. I wouldn't know.
Yeah.
I've been to uni. I didn't like it. Like, they ask you to do essays and things, and you think, you know, why are they asking me this crap? All they want to do is get me to crap on paper.
Are you a people watcher?
Oh yeah.
What sort of observations do you make about your customers?
Oh, you make lots of observations. Observations. You know, we just sort of, you try and basically guess, you know, is this person married, or, you know, where do they live, if they enjoy their work, should they be really having, you know, a drink?
Do you have a relationship at the moment?
No.
Is that recently finished or never had one?
No. No, it's not recently finished, but I suppose it was recently finished, yeah. But
what sort of things do you like in a partner?
Well, I just someone that sort of, you know, has decent conversation, you know, is easy on the eye.
What about sense of humour? Is that important?
Yeah, you gotta have a sense of humour.
Goes without saying, does it?
Yeah, as long as they're not bagging me out too much.
Uh-huh. Well, here we are at your workplace.
Yeah, this is my workplace.
You arrive with an escort.
Yeah.
We'll follow you.
Lisa.
So this is
the owner, Bob.
Hello, Bob. Hi. So you come in here and...
I'm upstairs.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And you're working in the bar. Let's show us upstairs.
Okay, let's go upstairs.
This
is Karen Cartier.
Hello.
And Megan. Who are they?
They're from SBS.
How busy does it get?
It gets pretty busy.
Yeah?
It gets really busy.
Do you juggle bottles and...
No. Only if we pretend.
In all this meeting with people, have you learned anything about people? Do you think you know people?
You can never begin to know other people. You can only assume, you know, things. But I think I have a fair idea.
Yeah?
Sometimes.
And what do you think of the human race?
I think it's great.
Huh?
Sometimes I sort of get a bit, you know, there'll be, you know, someone who think, my God, I'm sick of people like that. But most of the time, you know, people are, you know, very, very, you know, you get a lot, get to see a lot of bonding here. You know, I mean, sure, it's alcohol and juice, but it still happens. You know, people are really friendly. This is, you know, a social thing. People come together basically to have a good time and, you know, to see one another. So that can't be a bad thing, can it? You've got to have a good time, and you've got to do what you want and what you've got to do. It may change every day, but you've still got to make yourself happy, and that's the only... I mean, regardless of anyone else. You've got to be very selfish with those things.
Just think about it. presenter from SBS Television. You look so comfortable and relaxed, I thought we'd come and bother you. Do you live around here?
Yeah, just down the end of the street.
What do you do?
I'm a caterer in here.
Are you?
Yeah. Yeah, till uni next year. That's what I'm doing till the end of this year.
Right. And then what are you going to do when you leave uni?
Be an art teacher.
What sort of art do you like?
Surrealism and more obscure art instead of just plain normal stuff. Like I like different stuff, mystic stuff.
Right. What is there? Is that purple thing on your neck? Is that a mystic?
Yeah, it's amethyst.
Yeah, what does that do?
Just a crystal. These two together are more paganistic than Christianity. Christianity's man-made, paganism's man-made. Paganism was around before Christianity. So I find more truth in paganism than I do out of Christianity because I was brought up as a Christian.
Mm-hmm. So you've done a backflip.
Yeah, like I went through Christianity and then by the age of 17 I was out of it. For the last 7 years I've been following my own beliefs.
Are there any rituals or any things that...
Yeah, there's one coming up this week, the 30th of October. It's called Samhain.
It's called?
Samhain.
Samhain?
Halloween, Samhain.
Yes. What does that involve you doing?
It's a celebration of the dead, like celebrating, like you celebrate Christmas of a birth, so Samhain's celebration of the death, so, I don't know, having a celebration for the people that have, that have died.
That's like Catholics going to church.
Yeah.
Except you don't go to church, you go to?
A coven.
A coven.
Yeah.
Isn't the coven also a name for a group of witches?
Yeah, that's what my religion is.
Right.
All I can say is that I'm a Wiccan. That's my religion, Wicca. Witchcraft is just getting along with life in general, like loving life and like learning to live with your surroundings, learning to live with nature instead of destroying it, instead of destroying your fellow man, learning to live in balance with everybody.
So in fact it's a positive.
Yeah.
Force.
Definitely. Yeah.
Most people perceive it as a negative.
That's right. That's because of all the stuff that you hear. Like you hear in the States and like in Sweden and all this about all these black magic, you go around sacrificing babies and use blood and all this. Like that's just, it's got nothing to do with what I do, put it that way. Like that is totally opposite to what I believe.
Are you married?
No.
Do you have a relationship?
Sort of.
Did you find that person in the coven?
No, I found that person through a friend.
So that's completely separate, the social...
Yeah, they don't, none of my friends know about what I do, but they're just my friends, no. Because it's just something...
It's not that obvious.
It's not something that I can go revealing to somebody, like, say, this is what I've been doing, this is what I'm doing tonight, this is what I'm going to do this weekend.
Your partner, does your partner know?
Yeah.
And is your partner a pagan?
No.
Is he or she going to
she
be? And is she going to
it's
be?
She and... I don't know, I'd like it a bit, but whether it's her decision.
Have you talked about it?
Yeah. She's pretty open-minded, but I don't know, when she's ready, like you can't force anybody into it. I'm happy, so it's the main thing.
Disturb you for a second? We're from SBS.
Oh, okay.
We asked if it's okay to have a chat to you when you're finished.
Oh, fair enough.
With the dominant male's position.
You tend to have favourites. For some reason, a chimp will take a liking to you for a while, then you go back to being just a keeper again.
How much do you handle them? How much physical contact
Never go in with them whatsoever. They're very strong. Male about six times, a full-grown male about six times, and a female about four times. They're incredibly territorial animals. Just the same as... you know, the Doberman you have in your backyard. They're just protecting their territory. But because you've got so many, they tend to wind each other up and you'd very quickly be attacked.
So how did you get the job?
I used to volunteer here years ago. And as you know, there was an accident with a keeper who unfortunately was killed. And that required more keeping staff. So when you're working with dangerous animals, two keepers work together. So you would always check each other's locks and make sure there was definitely not an animal in the exhibit you're about to go into. And I was employed because of that.
Does your wife work with animals, or has she?
Well, Claire, she's a psychologist, so got a lot from there. I guess what a psychologist and a zookeeper would have in common is the mutual bond of behaviour.
Is there something that you learn about human beings from studying animals and vice versa?
Definitely the one thing I've learnt with animals, and it can be applied to human beings, is the way they treat their offspring. And in fact, I met Ernie Dingo a few months ago while he was here, and he said Aboriginals treat their children the same way chimps do, and that is they pass them around, I presume a lot of other native people do as well, they pass the child around from person or animal to animal, so they get comfortable with a wide range of people, and they quickly learn to lose fear they have of strangers. But obviously in a human culture with so many weird people around, it's not possible to do it, which is very unfortunate, because it is really, really good way to bring up kids.
Do you believe that there is a genetic link from apes to man?
Me personally, no, but we're very, very closely related. I can accept that. They're 98-99% identical genetically to us, but I don't believe in the theory that we all came from one single-celled organism. We are related, certainly, there's no denying that. Too many taxonomists have showed how close we are to them, but not. I don't think we came from them.
Is your belief based on scientific questioning or religious?
Religious, but to me they both require faith, because there's no proof that we all evolved from one being either. So.
Is there an anecdote you can share with us? An incident, perhaps, that sticks in your mind?
One. Actually, most of them involve the orangs, which are pretty close to my favourite. One thing that stands out in my memory is some working the orang house one day, and I heard a frantic knock on the back door of the orang house. The member of the public ran around and said, "One of your orangs has a possum. You'll need to do something about it." The female possum, the one he'd actually had, got up above him into a false ceiling, and he couldn't get through to her. But I heard a squeaking. And I looked down, and in a big pile of shredded paper was a very, very young possum that she must have thrown to lighten her load so she could get away. So I yelled to the male that was in there, whose name was Archie, and he was quite an aggressive animal, at least he was that day. And I said, "Give me that possum." And he just completely ignored it. So I had the other keeper I was with run around the back and grab a banana and come around the front again. I said, "Okay, Archie, give me the possum." And he picked up a handful of paper, turned the possum toward me, and I thought he was going to slam it into the bars, but actually put it through the bars really gently, yeah, and fell into my hand. And that animal's hand reared and released about 6 months later. So that brought a real tear to the eye. It was terrific.
And he got the banana?
He got the banana, yeah. He was happy and we were happy. Yeah. And the public was happy. Yeah. And they saw that interaction, that intelligence that the animals have. Yeah. I mean, maybe they're more intelligent, we don't know.
This is an Endomulomester top. It's part of a Belgian designer, which is part of the up-and-coming, if you like, designers happening in Europe. This is by a guy called Martin Magella, and he takes old clothes, recuts and remakes them, and just puts them back together again. He specialises in using old fabrics. Uh-huh. I mean, this is what they call grunge look, and it's definitely disappearing out of the fashion scene.
But this is grown-up grunge.
Grown-up grunge, yes.
Right.
Well, grunge is really something that students wore as streetwear. Right. I'm fashion buyer, so I get to travel. In fact, I've just come back from 4.5 weeks in Europe 2 days ago, so I go away twice a year. I get to have best of both opportunities. I live here in Sydney, which I love, and I get to go away to Europe and view other cultures and participate in them.
Do you have a husband or a boyfriend?
I have a boyfriend, but he lives in Paris, so...
So travelling is not a problem as long as you go to Europe?
Well, that's right. I mean, we probably only see each other every 3 months, but he's coming back to Australia to live after Christmas, so...
And I presume you met on one of your trips?
No, I met him here in Australia. He's English, and he lived in Paris for some time, and he's back there working at the moment. And he's on a project which is quite interesting, out in the country, just out of Paris, so...
What sort of project can you tell us about?
He's renovating a very old 400-year-old building on a farm property.
And how exactly did you meet?
Where did we meet? We met in Bondi Beach.
What one doing?
Sitting there chatting away with some friends, yeah. Yes. Both of us were... It was during the week. I wasn't working at that particular time. I was having some time off between jobs. And we met that way.
Uh-huh. And that was how long ago?
A year ago.
So it's, how often have you seen him?
Well, until he went away 6 months ago, I saw him reasonably frequently. And now, it's the first time I've seen him in over 3 months, yes.
Is that good for the relationship?
Does the absence
make the heart grow fonder?
I think it does, actually. It creates quite a different bearing on it. Going back to see him is like readjusting again. And also, he was working and I was working, so we had to fit into seeing each other amongst very busy schedules.
Yeah. What does your current boyfriend have that appeals to you?
He has a sense of individuality. He has a person with a lot of integrity. I like him for all those basic qualities.
Have you ever been married?
Yes, I have been, many years ago.
For how long?
3 years.
So that was fairly...
I was very young, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. I have a daughter.
Right. And how old is she?
She's 25. She works for a magazine, Elle magazine. She's a fashion stylist.
So she's in fashion too?
Yes, she is, yeah. Yes. And very successful.
How was it being a single mum?
Difficult. Mm. Not insurmountable. I mean, I still managed to have a career and create one. But,
how did you do that? Because a lot of women would find that very difficult, bringing up a child and having a career.
Well, the impetus began very quickly because at the time my child was three, such things as family support and things didn't exist. So one worked.
Yes.
Or you stayed with your family.
And so. When you were working, where was your daughter?
She initially... I paid for a nanny to look after her, and then initially she went to very early creches, like small kindergartens, and she continued in those till she went to school.
And did you ever feel that you were, you know, this is, I'm not suggesting that you should have, but I'm just asking, did you ever feel that you were kind of doing the wrong thing by her?
Oh, that often happened.
Guilt,
yes, of not being with her constantly. But over the years, you get to resolve that with your children. It's like the issue becomes, well, unless this occurs, her life doesn't go forward either. So, and she appreciates, understands that now.
And you have a good relationship?
Yeah, we have a great relationship. We're like friends.
If you look back on your life now, I mean, was that perhaps the hardest thing that you had to deal with?
I think in my early 20s, yes. Definitely. But I also wouldn't change it again, actually. On retrospect, it was like, I think it occurred, it was meant to take place, and it happened, and overall, I think it's turned out to be really successful, and I have no regrets about it.
Is there anything you'd change?
Maybe I would have liked to have travelled earlier when I was younger rather than starting later. But no, not really. I mean, through that, I obtained a lot of experiences, work experiences, a lot of opportunities, and my tenacity kept me going.